Good evening, Wanda Faye here. It is Wednesday, June 23, 2021. Let's get right into the word here because I need it, and I'm sure you do too. Psalm 56. Be merciful unto me, O God, for man would swallow me up. He fighting daily oppresseth me. Mine enemies would daily swallow me up, for they be many that fight against me, O Thou Most High. What time I am afraid, I will trust in Thee. Hallelujah. In God I will praise His word. In God I have put my trust. Yes, I will not fear what flesh can do unto me. Every day they wrest my words, all their thoughts are against me for evil. They gather themselves together, they hide themselves, they mark my steps when they wait for my soul. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you know all about everything. And actually, I don't think people are really thinking that about me, but you know what the enemy behind the scene is, and he's defeated in Jesus' name. So let's go over here to Acts 28. And when they were escaped, then they knew that the island was called Melita. The word of God is instantaneous on the scene, instantaneous word of God, Jesus Christ. And when they were escaped, then they knew that the island was called Melita, and the barbarous people showed us no little kindness, for they kindled a fire and received us every one, because of the present rain and because of the cold. And when Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and laid them on the fire, there came a viper out of the heat and fastened on his hand. And when the barbarians saw the venomous beast hang on his hand, they said among themselves, no doubt this man is a murderer, whom though he hath escaped the sea, yet vengeance suffereth not to live. They figured that if he had a snake latch on to him, that he must be he must have done something bad. A lot of people will attribute bad things happening to people in that way, because we're all kind of screwed up. We've been screwed up by different teachings, and I don't know where that comes from, hell, but you know what I'm saying. You know, don't lean to your own understanding. When bad things happen to people, it doesn't mean they have done bad. It means, well, let's just keep reading here. And he shook off the beast into the fire and felt no harm. Howbeit they looked when he should have swollen or fallen down dead suddenly, but after they had looked a great while and saw no harm come to him, they changed their minds and said that he was a god. In the same quarters were possessions of the chief man of the island, whose name was Publius, who received us and lodged us 3 days courteously. And it came to pass that the father of Publius lay sick of a fever and a bloody flux. That's funny, isn't it? To whom Paul entered in and prayed and laid his hands on him and healed him. So when this was done, others also which had diseases in the island came and were healed, who also honored us with many honors. And when we were departed, they laded us with such things as were necessary. Father, I thank you for your word. I love the book of Acts. And I just come to you right now and lift up all of our lives and our loved ones to you, Lord. Satan, we bind you. You are bound in Jesus' name. I thank you, Father, for your power. Your power. Infuse us with your power. Infuse us with healing. We come to you, Lord, right now, and we thank you for healing. Healing, healing. Be healed in Jesus' name. And prosperity, prosper, prosper. Make a way where there seems to be no way, Lord. And you are the way. Hallelujah. We just put our trust in you, and we thank you, God, that you're with us, and you're a miraculous God. You are God of heaven and earth. There's nothing impossible with you, Lord. So protect us and our loved ones, friends, family, loved ones, neighbors, neighborhoods, towns, cities. Oh, Lord, we come against this crime. We come against this awful, evil crime. And you know what? If the Democrats in these cities would have clamped down on the rioting and made a statement by calling in the National Guard, this crime wave would not be happening. Because there was no crime when everybody stayed in during the pandemic. Remember that? Oh, yeah, there was a little bit here and a little bit there. But, you know, people are crazy. People are totally insane. You give them a little rope, and they'll take a mile. The evil-doing criminals out there. So we come against it right now. We take authority over it. We override the Democrat policies in these cities. You come down, Lord, and pounce down on the criminals. Arrest them in the spirit, figuratively, not literally pounce down, because if you say that on social media, they'll interpret that as like we found out recently that I don't want to go into it, but Google is not the big brother, they're the big father, big daddy. Because they want to control what we hear, what we see, what we read. They're like the CCP, Google. They're like the Communist Chinese Party in America. Yeah, that's what they are. They love to play games, too. And so that's fine. God is above it all. God Almighty is above it all. He's greater than all of it. And we thank you for setting your people free, Lord, to live above it and live through it. Like you walked through waters, like you walked on water, and like you walked through walls, Lord. Social media has to bow its knee. The big tech guys, you have to bow your knee to the name of Jesus Christ. It's your choice. If you want to go to heaven, that's your choice, not my. I've already chose to go to heaven. And submitted myself to Jesus Christ, said that he died for my sins and come into my life. It's as simple as that. So, the Bible, and I was reading it this morning in John 6, I believe, that no man can come to the Father, but no man can come to the Lord, but through, lest the Father draw them. So, Lord, we pray that you, God Almighty, the Father, would draw people to Jesus. They would come to Jesus and get saved in Jesus Christ's holy name and repent of their sins. Just like we all have to repent of our sins. Every single day, we're held accountable by God as Christians. Okay? So, Father, work it out. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, everybody, God bless you. God bless you. Protect you.